कया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरौ श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरुं वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं श्रीकृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिन्धा दीनबन्धा जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कान्ता राधाकान्ता नमोऽस्तुते। तप्त काञ्चन गौरङ्गी राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। नमो महाबलान्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायिने कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः। पञ्चतत्त्वात्मकं कृष्णं भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकं। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासवि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। जन्माद्यस्य तोन्मयादितवत् चार्थेशुभिज्ञस्वराने ब्रह्म हृदयादिकवये मुह्यन्ति यत्सूरयः तेजो वारिं मृदां यथा विनिमय यत्र त्रिसर्गो मृषः धाम्ना स्वेन सदा निरस्तकुहकं सत्यं परं धीमहि। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। स्वस्ति अस्तु विश्वस्य खलः प्रसीदतां ध्यायन्तु भूतानि शिवं मिथो धिया। मनश्च भद्रं भजता दधुक्षजे आवेश्यतां लोमतिरभ्यहेतुके। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद्भागवतम कैंटो 6 चैप्टर नंबर 17 So we learn how Chitraketu, he made some strong remarks against Lord Shiva while he was in his plane, and Shiva, he did not react adversely, he just kept smiling. So also the other sages were assembled there. But Parvati, she became upset. And out of anger, she cursed Chitraketu to become an asura, so that he would not make such a mistake again. Because he has made criticism of Shiva, who is great sages, Brahma. So when Chitraketu heard this, he also did not react adversely. He came down from the plane and he bowed down to Parvati. And he said that, I accept your curse. Please you, Exactly. He said that whatever happens, it happens. Even if you have karma. So you are not at fault. If you did this, you were inspired because I was supposed to get the X amount. But then, whenever you have to get some result of karma, then your mind changes like that. Do something or you speak to somebody in a particular way and then you will get to it. So we think that it happened because of this particular situation or somebody else did it. But actually, it's because of karma and situation or you're in such a way. So this is how Chitraketu was thinking that I was supposed to get this body of Asura. Therefore, Parvati was inspired to curse me like this. And I was horrified that Lord Shiva didn't say anything, no one else said anything. So he's thinking in this way. Although he read in the commentary by Vishwan Chakrabi Thakur that it's not possible that he has any karma. Because Vidyate Hridaya Granthe Chidyante Sarvashman. As darshan of Lord and an outcome of devotion, then no karma or any trace of karma remains. So he said that it's natural for Chitraketu to speak like this because he is a devotee. For out of humility, he said so. So he continues to speak. Says samsara chakra tasmin jantura jnana mohitaha bhamyam sukham cha dukham cha bhunte sarvatra sarvada. So he is saying that it is nothing extraordinary what has happened to me. Because this whole material world is like that. That everybody in this material world is under the influence of ignorance, the jnana mohita. And out of ignorance we make mistakes. And sometimes we get some happiness, sometimes we suffer because of the mistakes. And this is how life goes on. Everybody can do the influence of it. Nadiya Vidya Samyukta. So, avidya has no beginning. And therefore the condition of living being has no beginning. And person continuously goes on and on. नैवात्मान पुरश्चापि कर्ता स्यात् सुख दुःखयोः कर्तारं मन्यते प्राज्ञः आत्मानं परमेव च. Actually then the suffering is not coming from others or from oneself. But out of ignorance we think like that. That other people are causing suffering. All suffering is just the nature of this world. So if someone said that is not coming because of this curse, and what is the cause for it? So he said it's not that Atma himself or the other they are causing. So in the karma, but atma actually is beyond karma. So karma they are bringing the result. And it will come as happiness and distress. Guna pravahaya tasmin kashapa kono bhaha kvasara bhavana kako vatam sukham dukham yava. So now he is basically speaking more from the philosophical point of view. So he says, and then he is trying to actually make Parvati feel good, so that she does not think that she made a mistake and repents. So this is characteristic of Vaishnava, that they don't want to trouble anybody. And when he was speaking harshly about Lord Shiva, he was not interested in criticizing him, although it appeared like that, and people would take it that way. That was actually not his intention. His intention was so that people don't criticize him. So now also he is thinking that Parvati is going to repent, lament, that she pronounced this curse. So she is making, he is making her feel comforted. Nice-hearted person, instead of getting angry, upset, or criticizing him back, he actually making him feel good. You don't have to feel bad about it. It has to happen, but it happened. It's my God. So it's quite an extraordinary thing to say. Such a situation, people make some bad remark about you, you immediately react. And if you don't react, at least you feel some disturbance inside. Sometimes you may not be in a position to react, but you feel bad inside, angry, frustrated. But Chitraketu was not feeling like that at all. Only he is going to get an asuric body, going from the body of Vidyadhara. So what a contrast, becoming from angel to demon, and he is not disturbed. Rather he is trying to make sure that Parvati is not disturbed. So this is quite an amazing thing. I read one story. This Kumbh Mela. So sadhu there, they were in camps, with camps, and also individual people living in some small huts. So one man, he was going, and then he knew that one sadhu was living in a hut, and he knew. So he thought that he would go and visit him. So he went to visit him. This sadhu, when he was sitting inside, he was actually smoking. And then he saw the other man coming, and he thought that he must have seen him smoking. So he was trying to hide. And obviously he was feeling bad that now he may taunt me, or he may criticize me, he will go around and tell others. Smokes. So this man, he actually saw him smoking when he came in. He sat with him, he asked him, how are you? And then he said, you know, I just had my lunch and I'm having some problem. And I have heard that if I smoke, it will be good to have something. So he said, yes, yes. He gave him to smoke, and then he not a smoker, so you just make sure it is, now I feel better. And then he left. So the other person felt very comfortable. He said, well, he is smoking himself, and he's not going to criticize me. So although this man, he was not, he never smoked, and he didn't want to smoke, but he knew that he's feeling bad when I saw him. So later on the sadhu, he came to know that actually the man was not smoking. He was talking, oh, this is what happened. He said, but he doesn't smoke. So he said, yes, not to smoke. He said, no. So then he understood why he did it. And from that point on, he decided to give up smoking. So this is some extraordinary example of not being critical of others and also not making others feel bad. So this is what Chittaketu was doing. So he's basically trying to philosophize that there's nobody is the cause of our happiness and distress, etc. But you know, he's saying that so it's guna pramava, this is all the gunas, as Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita. Prakrita yapajamana nivani karmani sarvusha. Ahankara mula atma karta hamati mandate. That everything is happening by the gunas of Prakriti. So, this is one way of seeing. We really see from the philosophical point of view that only the Buddha is inside. It's moving. Because body is made of the gunas. And gunas undergo changes. Sometimes sattva is permanent, sometimes rajas is permanent, sometimes tamas is permanent. And the atma has nothing to do with it. The atma is transcendental to the gunas. So atma is not the doer. It's only because of ignorance we start thinking that we are the doer. So the Lord says, guna pravahe vasana, etas karsha apokvamana. He says, what is curse, what is blessing? It's all gunas. So there's no blessing, there's no curse. It's all the play of gunas. So this is of course, this is how a jnani thinks, someone who is following jnani marga, he thinks like that. This path of jnana is based on knowledge and discrimination between self and the body. And they try to see themselves as aloof from the body and see how things are happening, so there is nothing which can disturb them. They don't identify with anything. So then you can see that it's all, whether it is suffering or enjoyment, it's all gunas. So suffering comes because of tamas. So sattvam sukhe sanjayati raja karmani bharata. Sukha, happiness, there is sattva, dukha, there is tamas. So this is all outcome of gunas and nothing else. So therefore he says that this is this cycle, this chakra, it goes on. Like day and night, like that. Everybody undergoes through the cycle of sukha and dukkha. Sometimes happiness, sometimes distress, sometimes happiness, sometimes distress. So therefore it says that you have nothing to do with it. You have no role to play in it. It has to happen to me. I was enjoying before, So tamasas to phalam dukkham. So the outcome of tamas is suffering. So sattva-sanjaya-ta-jnana-dosa-lobha-yajna. From sattva comes knowledge, happiness. And from rajas comes lobha, greed, and bewilderment. So rasas to phalam dukkham comes from jnana. Rajas brings suffering and tamas brings ignorance. So therefore he says, kva sarva narka ko va kim sukham dukkham. एक सृष्टि भूतानि भगवान आत्माया एषां बंधं च मोक्षं च सुखं दुःखं च. There is one supreme lord and he is under control. He is the one who creates and he is the cause. As liberation or bondage, happiness or distress, ultimately he is the cause of all causes. So ayam cha samsara chakrasya svabhava evam chitram apragya aveki evam tavat suk dukhadika mangi kritya uktam idanim tu lavanakare patita sarvo lavan rasayam samsare sarvev padartha samsare. So he said, just like if you fall into the ocean, then all around you taste is salt. So lavanakare patita sarvo lavan rasayam. So like that you fall into the samsara, this material world. So everything is mixture of sukha and dukkha, because that's what samsara is. Samsara means combination of happiness and suffering. So if you are inside it, then you cannot avoid these things. Unless of course you rise above the gunas. Nahi atala sparsha pravaha madhye patitasya yavat tatana vapti tavat kimapi uspita sukhaya iti svapanam dhadikam sarvam. So Vishnu Chakrati says that unless one goes to the beach or the bank of the ocean or river, when you are in the middle of it, then you will be thrown this way or that way. You cannot avoid it. So yavat tata anavapti, as long as you reach the tata, the bank, tavat kimapi vastuna sukhaya, he says there is no happiness. He is saying that even this so-called happiness is also dukkha. So although the verse is saying that there is, he says kim sukham dukkham eva, he says what is happiness and what is suffering. He says it's all suffering. But as long as you are inside, thrown in the midst of the ocean. So what is enjoyment? You're only striving to reach the beach. And unless and until you reach the beach, you will continue to remain in the trouble. You try to swim and look for them. So it says it's like. So sometimes, of course, you are in forgetfulness. Then you think you are not suffering in sleep. But suffering never leaves. Nani karyatra guna pravahaya ko va patayita ko va asma buddharta iti chet bhagavan. So he said that who is the one who can deliver us from this thing? So it's very good you are telling me. But how can I out of it? So he says there is only one person and that is Bhagavan. Supreme Person, Supreme Lord. He is the only one who can help. आत्माया रजसा सेवति सत्वेन पालति तमसा संहरति तेषां बंधन च विद्या स्मृति विद्या मोक्षं च सत्वेन सुखं तमसा मुखं च सो इट सेज इज माया थ्रू विच ही इज फंक्शनिंग सो बाय रजस ही क्रिएट्स बाय तमस ही डिस्ट्रॉयज by sattva, he manages it, he maintains. So these are the constitutional items, parts of prakriti. They are a type of energy. So sattva is the illuminating potency. When sattva is active, there is some illumination, some understanding. You can see things as they are. Then rajas is the active potency, the energy which acts. So when rajas is active, then you do something, it's quiet. And then tamas is which holds you, stable, stationary, no action, no illumination. So he says that with these three gunas he is acting in the world. So sometimes some gunas become prominent, then everybody is influenced by them. That's why some waves come, suddenly everybody starts becoming interested in something. This moment, that moment. Then the time goes, then something else comes. So this is our influence of the gunas. And accordingly some person comes, propagates that idea, and everybody listens to that. Then the time is over and no one cares for it. Somebody else cares. So these are all different waves of the gunas which keep coming and going. And Lord is the person who is controlling. So he says that through avidya, he creates bondage. Through knowledge, he creates liberation. Through sattva, he gives happiness. Through tamas, he gives suffering. But he himself remains free from maya, instant. Maya parati milanjamana. न तस्य कश्चित् दैत प्रतीपो न ज्ञातेर न बन्धूपरो न च स्वा समस्य सर्वत्र निरञ्जनस्य सुखेन राजा कृत एव दोषः सो सेड दैट ही इज न्यूट्रल इज उदासीन इंडिफरेंट नोबडी हु इज डियर टू हिम नोबडी हु इज Nobody is his relative, nobody is his own, nobody is other. Samasya sarvatam yuranyasya, he is equal, samam sarvatam, so Krishna is saying. Niranjanasya sukhena raga kutayam. So he is neither attached to happiness, nor he is angry in some disturbing situation. So we are opposite of that. When some favorable situation happens, we become attached to that. We have some good music, good food, and we enjoy that. If it is opposite of that, then we are disturbed. So we say that Lord is undisturbed. Equanimous states, even minded, no disturbance, balanced. And he wants that we also become like that. This is what he space in Bhagavad Gita. Sukha dukha samaya prattva lama lama jayana. Tato indhaya jasmi nam papam. Yoga stakur karma na sangam takva dhanam jayana. Siddhya siddhya samo bhukta samapam jayana. And so it becomes situated in yoga. Yoga means to remain balanced, which means not becoming influenced by the external situation. External situation will keep on changing, like the seasons, sometimes hot, sometimes cold, sometimes rain, sometimes comfortable. Balance in all situations. So that's yoga, that's how it is. And this is what Chitraketu and Swayambhu is an example. But when he was Vidyadhara, then also he was not a painter. And now he will become Vitrasura, now he's not disturbed. Because he's fixed, his mind is fixed on the Lord. Aham Haritam Padam Dasam Dasam Bhagdasam Bhagdasam. He says, I'm just servant and servant of your servants of your Lord's feet. So that is his nishtha, that is his sthai bhava, his permanent mood. He's not changing from that, he's not deviating. Then only one can remain balanced. Otherwise, you are like a boat without a captain, which goes wherever the wind is blowing. You're blowing to the east, you're blowing to the east, you're blowing to the west, you're blowing to the west. So that's what people are mostly, they're just following some waves, some wind, some fashion. एवं तावत् सुख दुखादिकं अनुसृत्य उक्तम्. सो ही इज एक्सेप्टिंग बोथ सुख एंड दुख. ननु तस्य कश्चित् प्रियो अप्रियश्च जीव अवश्यं वर्तते एव यतः कमपि बध्नाति कमपि मोचयति कमपि दुःखयति कमपि सुखयति इति आह. Question is raised that, Lord, you are saying that he is having this mastery of the three gunas, doing all these activities. So he also must have some people whom he favors, some people whom he punishes. Because we see that some people are bound, some people are getting moksha, they are getting liberated. So if they are getting liberated, then Lord must like them. Others he must not like. So he must have this division in his mind. And there are some people who are suffering. He is making them suffer. But if he is the master of the gunas, then he is responsible. That's what people say, that there is so much suffering and God is the cause of it. Upset with God. So he is making somebody suffer, making, and then he is making somebody happy. So he must have some discrimination, he must be biased. So the verse says no. Na gyate na bandhu, nobody is gyate, nobody is bandhu. Both words in Sanskrit mean relation. But one means relation with brother, means through friendship. तत्र हेतु सर्वत्र समस्या सबत्वे. So the reason for that is that he is even minded, he is balanced. And why is that? There is one word which is used here in the verse, that is called Niranjana. So Anjana is what you put in the eyes, that is called Kodajana. राजा So that is called Anjana. And God is called Niranjana. Means he has no color. Means his eyes are not influenced by anything. It's equal. So Anjana is also the word used for Maya. For the name is Maya. But it's not the real. Your eyes are not like that. Mascara? So that is Maya. Because the eyes are actually not like that, but they appear after you apply the mascara, they look different. So that is Maya. So Lord is called Niranjana because he is free from Maya. So Niranjana is used in philosophy. Ateva, Sukhe Vishaya, Sukhe Raga, Ashakti. So because he is free from Maya, therefore he is not attached to anything and he does not hate anything. So that is the meaning of Niranjana. Vishaya Sukh Prapti Kula Rosha Dvesha Kuta Shya Niruktam Indriyasya Indriyasya Arthi Raga Dvesha Vyavasthitam Tayo Vyavasa Nagatshe Tavriyasya Paripanthinam. So every sense has their raga and dvesha, their like and dislike. Everybody has some liking and disliking in each sense. A certain type of meaning one person likes, another person likes, another type. And a certain type you don't like. Some type of taste you like, some type of taste you don't like. Some people like pasta, some people like chapati. So because your sense has got raga and dvesha, like and dislike. So it has actually nothing to do with the object. And because of that, you feel happy with something and you don't feel happy with anything. Although we blame the object, actually object is neither good nor bad. That's why the same things can be good and bad depending how you feel with it. The same person who is your friend, he can also become your enemy. The same person whom you love, you start hating. But the person is actually neither object of love nor object of hate. It's all in our mind. Our mind is that which creates the duality. It's like when we breathe air, the air outside is just one air, but when it goes inside to the nostril, then it becomes, it has a different effect. Right? The left side is cooling and the right side is heating. Left side is called moon, right side is called sun. So same air gives different effects. Once it goes inside. So it becomes, it takes a dualistic nature. Air is not hot or cold, air is air, but has a defect. That's why they say that after eating, lie down to the left side, so that your right nostril will work more. It will create heat and digest your food. And if you are angry, then lie down to your right, so that your left nostril will work. Then you cool off. So like that, objects are neutral, but our senses, they make divisions of good or bad, like this. And because every sense is designed like that. From the previous, of course, they are all coming from the samskaras, from the past samskaras. If you like something because you have developed a taste for it, the type of food you are given in your childhood, naturally you like, start liking. And it's difficult to change it for the rest of your life. You have to work very hard फल से इंद्रिय से इंद्रिय से आते हैं, राग द्वेष और व्यवस्थित हो, सब इसमें व्यवस्था इन अरेंजमेंट एंड सेंस दे आर मेड ऑफ मैटर मेरा गुणा 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 इस वर्तन का ही कि मतवान सिद्ध है सो इट्स एक्चुअली ये प्ले प्ले ऑफ द गुणा द सेंसेस आर आल्सो गुणास मेड ऑफ प्रकृति एंड द ऑब्जेक्ट इज आल्सो मेड ऑफ द गुणास देयर डीलिंग विद ईच अदर वी हैव नथिंग एल्स टू डू विद इट आत्मा डस नॉट पार्टिसिपेट एनीवे बट बाय आइडेंटिफाइंग द सेंसेस देन यू स्टार्ट Doesn't happen to us. It's only happening outside. But because of identification, then sukha and dukkha, happiness and suffering come. But if we can stay aloof, then there's no cause of happiness, there's no cause of suffering. Atev raga dvesha mulako dhaita pratipo tasya nasta. Therefore, Lord, he remains balanced because his senses are not causing duality. Because his senses are not made of the guna of the prakriti. So he does not derive happiness or distress or suffering from sense objects. तथापि तच्छक्तिर्विसर्गेषां सुखाय दुःखाय हिताहिताय बन्धाय मोक्षाय च मृत्युजन्मनो शरीरिणां संस्कृतये कल्पते सो ऑल्दो द सिचुएशन इज लाइक दिस स्टिल ही एक्चुअली क्रिएट्स ए पॉसिबिलिटी फॉर दैट आउट So this Maya is that which is causing all these things. Tathapita shakti visharganesham sukhaya dukhaya hitahitaya bandhaya mokshaya cha mrityujanmano. So this duality is caused by Maya. So that means as long as we are experiencing duality, we are under the influence of Maya. How intensely we experience duality, that deeply we are entrenched into our influence mind. And as much you can rise above the duality, that means you are free from mind. And if you are completely free from duality, then you are mukta purusha. So this is the test. Which influence Maya has on you, you know, from the change in your mindset by external situation. Evam tasya samyam chet tarhi katham kamapi sa sukhayati kamapi dukhayati. So now it's asking question. You say that Lord is equal to everybody, then how is it that He is giving happiness to some and suffering to others? But you say that He is the master of Maya. This Krishna says, Devi Yesa Guna Mayi Mama Maya Duratya. This is my Maya. So if it is His Maya, then If suffering is coming to somebody, that means he is the one who is doing it. If somebody is enjoying, happy, that means he is giving it. And how can you say that he is equal to one? He is bearing some people and causing trouble to others. So for that he answers this. He says that although he is equal, but it is his Maya who is creating. see, Lord, but it's very difficult to understand this fact that God is equal to all and yet people are suffering. He is the controller and yet he is equal. How is this possible? If you are the boss of the company and you control everything, it's all the movement of people. And some people are happy and some people are suffering, and you say that it is you who are doing it, that you are controlling even their breath. So how to make you free from that? And you say, no, no, but actually you are equal to all. So the solution is through Maya. You have to bring some other factor in between. You call it Maya, you call it karma, fate, whatever. So yadyapi sa sarvatra samas tadapi tasya shaktya maya yogisarga. Although he is equal, still his maya, which is his potency, she is the one who creates. Nadi Punni Papadi Lakshmi Karam Parampara Saiva Sukhadi Ratana. So then you say Maya. So Maya, you know, you blame Maya. So Maya also, it says, it is Anadi. It has no beginning. So then comes karma. So ultimately, so he said it is the flow of karma, and in the form of good action and bad action. You do some actions which are favorable, merit, demerit, papa and punya, and that leads to happiness and distress. And this is anadi, this has no beginning. God has not placed you in the material world, therefore you cannot blame Him. You also did not make any choice to come here. You have been here without any beginning. So, Anadi Punya Papadi Lakshmi Karam Parampara. This flow of karma is what is bringing happiness in this place. So, therefore, you have to get out of this place. And what the meaning is this? Yadyapi Mayaya. Tachaktitvat saiva sukhum khadikam swisti iti tasya vasamya meva tadapi maya swarup shaktitva bhavat saina sukhdu khadisri jati iti vasputas tasya samyam. So he says that even if you say that it is maya which is causing it, but maya is his energy. Maya is not working independently. Therefore, ultimately, he is responsible for creating happiness and suffering. And therefore, there is biasness in him. So he says, yes, we accept that Maya is his energy. And Maya is not independent. But the thing is that Maya is not part of his swarup shakti. It is not his internal potency. It is outside him. And that's why the duality comes and he is not there. If it was part of its swarup shakti, then you can say. Means Maya, although it is his energy, but he has employed, he has given a field for Maya to look after. And then Maya is looking. So although Maya is supported by him, this is what Vyasa saw in his Samadhi. Vyasadeva wrote Bhagavatam. Before that he sat in Samadhi. So he saw this Maya also. Bhakti Yoga and Mansi Sambhat Pranihitai Male Apashyat Purusham Purnam Mayam Chatat Apashyat. So he sat in the Samadhi Bhakti Yoga and he saw Supreme Lord. He also saw Maya. But Maya was apashraya, means away from him. All that was under his shelter, but it was removed from him. So therefore Maya is the cause of this. So she is calling him up in the first place. Vastuta tasya sam, therefore Lord is free from any bias. यथा माये पुरुषस्य भगवत रूपत्वे अपि न भगवत स्वरूप तत्त्वम् इति. सो इस ही गिव्स एन एग्जांपल. सो जस्ट लाइक दिस वर्ल्ड व्हिच इज मेड ऑफ माया इज आल्सो मेड फ्रॉम माया एनर्जी. इट इज आल्सो फॉर्म ऑफ गॉड विराट स्वरूप यूनिवर्स बट इट इज नॉट इन हिज स्वरूप. देयरफॉर वी डोंट वर्शिप दिस. You can also look at it as God, but this is not the worshipable God. Yatha surya sambandhina atapasya bhuka kumudadinam dukhetutvena chakravata amaladinam sukundatvena vasamya pi surya satesu vashamya kopina varna. Now he gives a very nice example. Say just like sun. So the sunlight comes and owl is not happy because he cannot see. So it gives trouble to the eyes of the owl. And kumuda, this type of flower, it closes when the sunlight comes. So this is the cause of suffering for them. And then there is a word called Chakravaka. Feels very happy when the sun comes. So they believe that Chakravaka and Chakravaka, male and female, they become separated at night. And they feel great separation all night. And when the sun comes, then they can meet. But at night, then we have lotus flower which blooms when the sun appears, closes when the sun goes down. So he says that the sun is giving happiness to the lotus and Chakravaka bird and suffering to owl and kumuda. But that does not mean that sun is biased. No one says that sun is biased. The sun is giving light to everybody equally. If someone is suffering because of them, someone is
can you just mention a little bit about Swarup Shakti, his Swarup Shakti, what is the, what are the qualities of that, just so that...
Swarup Shakti is the spiritual energy of God which makes a person feel inclined towards him. And so if you become influenced by this energy, then you become devoted to God. Your mind naturally.
And so, but there's qualities associated, love and
yes,
kindness and compassion associated with that.
It's the potency of love.
Potency of love.
So it's just like he says that when someone is under the influence of this energy, as soon as he or she hears about my quality of mind, immediately becomes attracted and flows towards him. I know. water when the wind blows the ocean. So it's like now our minds are not moving towards God because we are influenced by Maya. So we think of my things, my actions, my concepts, my relations. And we become influenced by Antaranga internal potency and think only of God and things related to natural.
Where is this talked about and explained? What text is this? Is there a place, one place that I could go and like look? I know he has the three energies, but I just haven't, like, I mean, I've heard you talk about it, but I haven't like read it anywhere where I can just really, is there some place where I could go and find it?
Yeah, I think Bhagavad Sundarbha.
Bhagavad Sundarbha.